Hello guys, my name is Kishan and today we are going to talk about control files in SQL Loader. So as we discussed in our previous video about SQL Loaders, a control file is the heart of an SQL Loader. Now if you have seen our previous video, you would understand that the SQL Loader is basically used to load any text file which has data in a particular format to get loaded into Oracle database tables, and there are various advantages of using this SQL Loader utility. Okay, so as we saw in the last video, SQL Loader would need a control file to actually find where the data is and process the data and then load it into the database. While doing so, SQL Loader would generate three types of log files: a regular log file, a bat file, and a discard file. Okay, so what actually this control file is? What is this heart of SQL Loader? So control file basically contains the DDL instructions which an SQL Loader engine would need to load the data. So think about it. What would it actually need to have? So first of all, it will have the location of the file which needs to be loaded. It will have the file path and the file name. The path is not really mandatory if the control file and the data file exist in the same location. We'll talk about this when we get into the demo. Okay, so basically it would have the location of the file which is to be loaded. It will have the table names in which the data has to be loaded from the file. Okay, now you can specify any particular formatting that you need to do on the file. You can specify conditioning, you can write kind of transformation logic in the control file, and in certain cases you can have the data itself in the control file. So when you are using an SQL Loader utility, basically all you need to do is write a control file, and it is very easy to write. You have lots of options. Sometimes when you go on the net to read about control file, they just throw you with all the information and you might get confused. In this video, we are going to take it in a way that we will first understand the basic concepts, the structure, and then as and when we'll keep on complicating our example and we'll learn more and more features. So what are the data format that a control file need to have? Now as we have discussed in the previous video, the data file needs to be in a particular format. It just cannot be any random way. So there are two ways in which you can have the data in a data file. Okay, so what are those two ways? You can have, the first format is delimited data format, meaning you will have a delimiter. Mostly a delimiter can be comma or a pipe symbol, but it's actually up to you to decide what delimiter you would prefer. Okay, so the data would look something like this. You will have the first column, as in here you can see 001, that will be my, say, ID. So then that ID, whenever that ID is ended, we have a comma, we have a delimiter which states like the first column ends here. Okay, then we'll have the second column. Say suppose it's the employee name, say Steve. Okay, then when the second column data ends, we have a comma stating that the second column ends here, and then the third column starts. Say the department ID 101. So this is an example of how delimited data can be present in the data file. Okay, so you can have multiple rows like this of data in the data file. Okay, the file can be saved in .txt or .csv format. What is the csv, txt, .dat format? We'll discuss about this in the next video. It is very easy. Sometimes when you are talking with your colleagues and you are thrown jargons like load the csv file or the data file, you might get confused, but it is actually plain text file. It is no different than .txt file, but it has data in a particular format, and that's why it is called csv and all. We'll talk about that. Okay, so this three rows that you see over here, having data for Steve, Bill, and Mark, similarly you can have it delimited with the pipe symbol. So pipe symbol can be shown like this. So it's basically the same data, but instead of a comma stating the end of a column, a pipe will state the end of the column. Okay, and the second format, which I am sure you'll not be going to use so much because it's not really that that easy or not really very flexible kind of to use. That is a fixed width data format. Now what a fixed width data format states is, you give a width, you give a particular characters to particular columns. I can say like my ID will be 3 characters, my name will be 5, and say my department ID will be again 3 characters. So the file will read like this: first, second and third characters goes to the first column, then starting from 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th would go to the next column, and the last 3 will go to the third column. Now this order is not really required, just for simplicity I am making it this way. You can really have any order over there. When we look at the example, actually we will see how all this happens. We actually will give position 4 colon 6, stating like from 4 to 6 is this column for this data for this column, things like that. So basically in a fixed width data format, you will have data something like this. You will have a string, a complete string, and your control file, you will write the control file in a way that SQL loader will understand, like, okay, take first three are my first column, then take 5, they're my next column, then take 3, they're my third column. So whenever you will come across data which actually falls short of your length, you will be putting spaces there. So it will just be like using a substring to parse the whole data, the substring function of an Oracle to parse the whole data. So these are the two ways in which you can have the data format. Now this is about the data file that we actually talked about. This is the way in which your data will be present. Now you need to understand this, because only after understanding this you can write a control file to read this data. So I hope this is clear. If anything, you can put me in comments. Okay, now we jump on to the control file. I have just given some color coding over here. It is a free text file. Okay, it is case insensitive. It is saved with a extension of .ctl, saying it is a control file. Okay, so the very first line over here, the options which I have marked in red is really optional. There's no need to write an options line in your control file, but sometimes you would like to have, you would like to tell the control file like, okay, load the data until I get 10 errors. If I get more than 10 errors, just don't load anything. So you can write options bracket error is equal to 10. Now there are multiple options available to give in the options clause. You can state error, you can state how much number of records you want to load, you can set if you want to skip any records, you can say that I don't want a feedback for say header or errors, and all those things can be set. There are various options available, but most widely used will be skip is equal to 1, because you would like to say like my data file contains an header and I don't want to insert that header into my table, so you will give skip is equal to 1. We'll look at that when we go for a demo. Okay, then we have the next line. You can put 2 enters after this, you can put 1 enter, you can just write in the very next line, that is load data. As soon as the control file reads load data, it understands like this is a session in which I have to do this loading. Okay, but before that I would like to mention that whatever you write in options line can also be written when you are actually calling the SQL loader. So when you are actually executing the SQL loader from your command prompt or from your batch file, at that very time you can mention almost all the options that you can mention in this option clause. So you can just omit the option clause here and mention all these things into the actual calling, actual syntax where you are going to call or going to execute the SQL loader. Okay, so load data starts like from here, the actual control file starts, and this is all going to happen in a single session. Okay, so that is load data. Then is INFILE. After INFILE, you can give path and the file name, or if the file is present in the very directory in which the control file is present, then you can directly give the control file the data file name. As in here I have given infile emp underscore data dot dat. Normally SQL loader by default understands the dot dat format, so there's no reason to actually write dot dat, but you can write it. other formats are also available which you can use, and you can just mention your like emp data underscore csv or emp data dot txt, and it will read it without any issues. And then you can see that I have written truncate. Now there are basically three options: one is truncate, one is replace, and one is append. What append does is it needs an empty table to put data in it. So if your target table is empty, you can write append, it will just put data into it. The second option is replace. What you actually say in replace is delete the existing data and put the new data. You need to have delete privileges on the target table. And the third is truncate. Truncate, what does truncate do? It truncates all the data from the table and then inserts the new data. Now any of you, if you have a doubt on what is the difference between delete and truncate, I'll put the video in the description. It's very different from each other. Please have a look. So after these three lines, load data, infile and truncate, or replace, or append, you have a clause of into table, table name. So here you will state into which table you want to really put this data. So you'll give into table and table name. Then for the delimited file, you will write this file terminated by and your delimiter in quotes. Okay, if it's a position file, this clause is not required. It will not make any sense. In that case, the syntax will change, like you will give positions, actual positions in adjacent to your column. So here, as you can see, because it is a delimited file, I gave field terminates by comma, and then I just opened up braces and give the three column names. So these three are the column names of this table. So I have given EMP ID, EMP name, and department ID. So what it does is it will look at my this EMP data.dat file. It will read the first three. It will read the first column until it gets a comma. As soon as it gets a comma, it will understand now the data for the next line starts. It will start putting that data into EMP name. As soon as it reads a comma, it will understand now this is the data for the third column, and it will put it here. Now if it is not a delimited file, if it's a position file, so you will just give position here. So you will give something like position 0 to 3 or 0 to 2, then position 3 to next whatever. It's not worth it by saying over here. I'll just do a practical demo and show you guys this. Okay, so this is how you write a control file. Yes, it ends there. This begin data is really optional. If you have very small amount of data to get loaded, you can just write begin data here and write the data here itself. So it's like this data or this data can be kept here. When you are doing that, your infile should have star actually. If you give an infile file name, it is really you are saying like get the data from the file. So if you are using begin data, you will have infile and star, meaning the data is there in the control file itself. Okay, and now one more thing. If you are going to give any comments, don't give after begin data, because it will read it as actual data. Yes, I don't know why it is made like that, but any comments after begin data will be considered as data itself. So as I mentioned before, this is a case insensitive file. You can write the way you want it. It's a free flowing file. You can put enters anywhere you want. It would really understand what you are trying to say. So this is about control files. Now what I'll do is in my next video, I will show what an actual data file would be, how it will look, and we will use that data file and the control file to load the data. So I have written a control file over here which I'll show you. So this is .ctl control file. So you can see that it is not getting any by default file type to open. Just do a left click and open with notepad++ or notepad, whatever you like. So this is the very file that I just showed you. Okay, this is the options clause, this is load data, this is the infile. Actually, it is a good practice to write the infile quotes open and your path, complete path, and the file name. In that case, you know you're really making sure to make SQL Loader understand where the file is. If it's in the same folder, you don't really need the path, only file name will do, but it's a good practice to put everything. Okay, then you can use truncate or replace or append. You can give the into table table name option. and this is basically the same file. I just wanted to open this file and show you how it looks. See, it's a pretty simple file over here, just 10-12 lines of code, and it loads your whole file into the table like in seconds. It's too fast and it's too good with excellent error handling and logging mechanism. So in my next video we'll look at a demo on that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please do like, share, subscribe and put your comments going. I would really like to know how you are feeling about the videos or any improvements or, you know, whatever you guys would like to discuss. This is Kishan signing off. Thank you.